everybody, and welcome to another episode of my blog series, Season 3. I'm Gyrorack, and I'm so excited to be doing my Part 3 of Happy Days / Joni Loves Chachi video. I'm so excited to be doing this video. Make sure to check out my previous two videos of Happy Days / Joni Loves Chachi. I'm so excited to be sharing with you guys my two new books of Joni Loves Chachi. The first book is called Secrets. Joni Loves Chachi first book, Secrets. I definitely recommend you guys to buy both of these books, read them, enjoy them. They are fictional books. They're not, as realistic as the episodes or the shows or anything, but they are really good books and they're really awesome to read. They're like novels, and I definitely recommend you guys to read them. So the first book is called Secrets, and it has to do with Joni and Chachi trying to buy Christmas presents for each other, and a misunderstanding occurs, and So let's just leave it at that. The first book is called Secrets, Joni Loves Chachi. And the second book, which I am currently reading, I just got these books. This one I got it Monday. This one I just got it Tuesday. I'm currently still reading them. The first one has 10 chapters. The second one has 11 chapters. And it's a really amazing book to also read. It's called A Test of Hearts. And it has to do with Joni. Her career goes off, and there's a test between the Joni and Chachi's love is tested, and so they're really good books. I definitely recommend you guys to read them, the Joni Loves Chachi books. And without any further ado, I am excited to do this video. And I'm so excited to be doing this video, so let's get started. I love to talk about Happy Days and Joni Loves Chachi because it's like an amazing puzzle that you find new pieces to. I recommend you guys to watch my previous two videos of Happy Days and Joni Loves Chachi to know more amazing information. I want to give credits to Wikipedia for most of the information that I found out for this video, and let's get started with this video. Happy Days had the spin-offs that I mentioned in my previous video. Joni Loves Chachi, Mork and Mindy, Laverne and Shirley, The Fonz and the Happy Days Gang. But there were three other spin-off shows that weren't really official spin-offs, but had two of the actors of the Happy Days in. The shows were called Blansky's Beauties, featuring Linda Goodfriend and Scott Baio, who play Lori Beth and Chachi on Happy Days. Nancy Walker played Howard Cunningham's visiting cousin, Nancy Blansky, from Las Vegas on the February 4th, 1977 episode of Happy Days. Blansky's Beauties premiered the following week on February 12th of 1977. Nancy Blansky Walker was a longtime Las Vegas showbiz bet since the 1950s and current den mother to a bevy of beautiful Las Vegas showgirls. In addition to keeping order in the chaotic apartment complex where they all lived, Nancy staged the girls' big numbers at the Oasis Hotel, although the Happy Days episode on which Nancy first appeared took place in the early 60s, Blansky's Beauties itself was set in then-present day 1977. Ethel Aquilino, known as Sunshine, was played by Linda Goodfriend, and Anthony DeLuca, played by Scott Baio. Anthony was forever trying to impress a character on the show named Bambi, who treated him like a kid brother, as did almost all Nancy's girls. So you can tell that Linda and Scott were playing different characters. Gary Marshall was involved in the projects, and the next show is called Who's Watching the Kids, also featuring Linda Goodfriend and Scott Baio. Who's Watching the Kids is an American sitcom which aired on NBC from September 22, 1978 until December 15th of 1978. It was produced by Gary Marshall. The series focused on two young Las Vegas showgirls working and rooming together who each had a younger sibling living with them. In this show, Linda plays Angie Vitola, and Scott plays Frankie, Angie's 15-year-old brother. Henry Winkler mentioned in one of the Happy Days reunions that he got to see Scott as a 10-year-old come on the set, but Scott was 15, so was his character Chachi, when he first appeared on Happy Days. So that means that he must have been 10 years old when he did Blansky's Beauties, 15, and Who's Watching the Kids, and at age 15 then transferred along with Linda to Happy Days. That is just my theory, but it makes sense. The next show is called Out of the Blue. Out of the Blue is an American fantasy sitcom that aired on ABC during the fall of 1979. It is chiefly notable as having featured a Mork and Mindy crossover and for the controversy surrounding its status as a spin-off of Happy Days. The series stars Jimmy Brogan as Random, an angel in training who is assigned to live with and act as a guardian angel for a family working as a high school teacher. The series aired from September 9th to December 16th of 1979. Nine episodes had been aired at the time of cancellation. Some completed material was never broadcast. Out of the Blue has engendered a debate amongst some viewers concerning its precise relationship to Happy Days. The controversy arises from the fact that the first episode of the show was broadcast a little over 1 week prior to an episode of Happy Days featuring Jimmy Brogan as the character Random. Television observer and owner of the sitcoms online, Todd Fuller, maintains that because Chachi Sells His Soul aired on September 18th of 1979, Random's appearance on Happy Days episode was a crossover. He goes on to postulate, the Happy Days episode was likely a promotional tool for Out of the Blue to make the character more known. So, as you can see, these spin-off shows were technically spin-offs, but at the same time were in, and unfortunately these shows lasted very little time. But it was awesome to see Linda and Scott come upon their roles on Happy Days, because that's what really highlighted their careers, and those are the characters that everyone grew to know and love. Musician and actress Susie Quattro was also offered a spin-off, for her character Leather Tuxedero, but turned it down. Changing a bit the subject, I'm going to give unknown facts about Happy Days and my favorite performances of Joni Loves Chachi. Happy Days was originally going to be set in the 1920s, but Gary Marshall knew more about the 1950s, so he was able to write the script starring in the 1950s. Number two. Erin first auditioned for the role, but didn't make it at first. But when Susan Nair was fired, Erin worked with Anson Williams before Happy Days, and Anson brought Erin to Gary Marshall's attention and gave him a good word for her. And Erin finally got the role, and we thank the Lord she did. I'm sure Susan was a really good actress, but you can't deny that when you see Erin, you see Joni. Joni is Erin, and what would we have done without Erin playing Joni? Life wouldn't be the same. Number three, Henry was offered another spin-off besides the animated series The Fonz and the Happy Days Gang, but turned it down because he was happy working with his cast members on Happy Days, and there was really no need for him to get comfortable with a new set of cast members when he already had a family on Happy Days. I love when Chachi wears a bandana around his leg, which, by the way, I wanted to get a bandana for this video, but unfortunately I couldn't. But for my next video, I definitely, hopefully, will have a bandana, because I love that bandana. Yes. I love when Chachi wears a bandana around his leg, but maybe you didn't notice that in the last episode of Happy Days, Joni wears a blue bandana that Fonzie gives her for her wedding. I think it's a cute tradition. I love Scott and Erin's chemistry. There is no doubt about how adorable they are. You get the feels every time you watch them, and I love how she defends him and he defends her. How when they're sick, they take care of each other. How they always have each other's backs, and how they're always there for each other. I remember watching an episode of Joni Loves Chachi where Chachi is afraid that he and Joni would grow apart. But Joni comforts him and assures him that that can never happen because they love each other and have something special. One of the most heartbreaking moments for me to watch was their last breakup. It was painful. Their other breakups were sad as well, but they always got back together and made it everything better. But that last breakup was hard to handle. I remember when I watched it for the first time, I got emotional. Not gonna lie. But like I said in my previous video, it all worked out for the best. They didn't grow apart. If anything, they grew closer together. They knew that they were gonna get back together sometime, just didn't know when, and never denied the fact that they still loved each other. And then the proposal. Plus the marriage. I believe it was at the perfect timing, and the breakup just gave that opportunity.